Hey guys. So an extended welcome from myself, Inventor Relations, and our fellow friends at Hasbro and the tables in front of me. The Taggy Awards is certainly a significant event for us and in the annual calendar. But it really is this chance to celebrate your journey, celebrate your success, and our partnership. You guys passionately dedicate huge amounts of time, resource, energy, providing that pipeline of innovation into companies such as ourselves, and that's certainly worth celebrating. I want to thank you all for that. Equally, it's important to recognize those who have significant contributions to us as a business and as an industry. And I have the pleasure of introducing tonight's keynote. He's someone who needs little introduction. He's one of the key ingredients of IDEO's global product design powerhouse. His passion for innovation, his infectious energy, his can-do attitude has founded IDEO's toy invention studio known as Toy Lab, based in Palo Alto, California. Through his team, they've commercialized hundreds of kid-centric products and partnered with localized and global industries and companies around the world. His spare time, he lectures at Stanford in a world-renowned design school, sharing his innovative wisdom and his knowledge, even being honored as a Knight Fellow Favorite Professor at the university. That's damn impressive. Beyond his work, his academic achievements, it goes without saying, he's a remarkable person, a great friend, an ambassador to the industry. He loves his cars, keeps himself in tip-top shape, and he's not bad with a golf club either. And on that note, I'd like to hand over to Brendan Boyle.
Hey, buddy. Thanks, everyone. Thanks for having me. All right. I teach a class over at Stanford. I always like to start a class with a real simple warm-up. Don't worry, you're not going to have to hold hands or anything. But it sends a signal to the class that this is going to be a safe place to innovate, to try some different innovation techniques. So this warm-up's going to center around things kids believe, things kids 3 to 5 year old believe. So I'm going to go through 5 of these. The world used to be in black and white. Does anyone believe this when you were a kid? If you look at an old black and white TV show or you look at an old photograph, it kind of makes sense. Back in the old day, at some point, it turned into color when I was born. If you swallow a watermelon seed, a watermelon will grow in your stomach. I think this may be attributed to a Rugrats episode. But more likely, there are things that kids believe that they deduce, like the first one. The second one's probably more parent-driven. We try to trick our kids all the time around telling them things like this, and it really influences them. People on TV can see me. I used to believe that. And now, if you're 3 years old and you just got off FaceTime with Grandma or Skype, heck, you watch a TV, of course those people can see you, right? So that one is real kid deduced, and it's a really interesting observation. Leave a rubber band on your arm too long and it will fall off. This is obviously parent-driven. I wear plenty of rubber bands, so it's not going to happen. And then lastly, the moon follows you around. And this makes sense if you're a kid, because you get in your car, it's night, and you're driving over to Grandma's, and it's 10 miles away. You get in the car, the moon's there. You drive 10 miles over there, and the moon's still there. Like, it had to follow you on the car path. So, all right, so now you're going to try this little warm-up exercise. You're going to work with your teams for about a minute. And you're going to, amongst your table, who has the most unique thing you believed as a kid? So do a little mini share here and see what you guys believed as kids. See if you have one more unique than that. So just spend a minute. I'm only going to give you a minute. All right, class. Shh. Okay, class. Okay, let's hear a couple from the audience. Rich has got a mic over here. Rich, what do you got?
Hello, Mike. Okay. Michael Kona.
Yeah, my daughter just told me that she used to think that when she listened to the radio when she was a kid, that the people were actually in the radio.
People in the radio, yes. Awesome. Who else? Over here.
Someone from our table believed that rabbits were born from magicians' hats.
Oh, rabbits were born with hats, magicians' hats. Cool. Rich, over there, Rich, you got to...
Okay.
I'm coming.
Last one, so it better be good.
No, it's got to be Jesus Pete. Ladies and gentlemen, Jesus Pete.
When I was a kid, I was in my dad's garage, and he had this outboard motor in the corner, like, mounted on this board. And underneath there, I found this pair of binoculars, and it was the coolest thing I ever found in my life. And I love those binoculars. I play with them every day. I'm like, I can see everything in the world. And I lost them one day. And so...
Hey, Pete, it's not your keynote. Hurry up and wrap this up.
I'm almost done, Brendan. I'm almost done, man. And so after I lost them, every day after that, I would go back to underneath that motor in the corner of the garage, and I'd look. I'm like, you know, I thought it manufactured binoculars.
Oh, all right.
But it didn't.
All right. Round of applause for Pete. We got one more.
One more here. Okay. We'll finish on a brief note.
It's fast. I had a baby girl in the closet.
Is that right?
No! No, I thought I did.
All right. Rich, we'll end up. We got a good one here, but we're going to end on that one on time sensitivity. So, all right, stop laughing out there. So we spend a lot of time observing 3 to 5-year-olds. A lot of time understanding their behaviors. And you kind of, for this part of the design process, I really think it's important to be inspired and to understand your user deeply. It's interesting, when you talk to a 3-year-old, they'll always say, I'm 3 and a half, I'm three in 2 months, I'm 3 in 1 week, because that half year is a big percentage of their age. I've yet to hear someone who's 45 say, I'm 45 and a half, right? So it's just, and then a lot of you have kids out there, and sometimes you're experts on kids, but sometimes you're experts on those kids. So it's important as a toy inventor to make sure you're getting exposure and observing lots of different types of behaviors. So I'm going to show you a few different pictures on things that we're seeing. Kids really see in detail, and they see what's right in front of them. That's all their attention's on that, and it's just so amazing to watch that sort of behavior. The now matters. So you know what's happening here, right? This is a great finger painting session. And I did a warm-up in my class where 35 grad students, I put finger paints and paint a paper out and said, 10 minutes, we're going to finger paint. This is Stanford, right? So they're finger painting, and they're doing pretty good. They're they're having some fun. And then afterward, I had them put all their hands up and took a top-down picture. 90% of the students, same thing. Red, a little bit of red on one finger, a little bit of green, a little bit of blue. You know, because this is all about the now, but for us as adults, we think we're planning, right? So all these students were like, oh yeah, in 20 minutes, I gotta get washed, I gotta get to another class, I gotta do all this stuff, right? So if you're trying to understand kid behavior, maybe an immersive activity, but then go all in, because it's about the now. Kid logic is kid schmogic, right? So I told him sunscreen doesn't matter. You don't need it when it's raining. I said he could take the store's display wagon of pink socks home. He couldn't take those home. And we think they're just having a meltdown. But in their logic, it's just like, hey, this is cool. I like putting on sunscreen, or I want to take this home, right? So understanding that. This is a nice little piece of creative play from constructive play, right? This is some constructive toys made into a drawing toy. Lovely sort of little example of observing something. Take a moment and look at this picture and see if you can figure out what's going on. This is mom and dad sleeping, a couple of different shirts, and then their legs and head are made out of books, and they actually have a little headboard for them to sleep on. Take a look at this and see if you can understand the play on this one. It's really delightful. The shoes are obviously beds, and the cars are taking, you know, they're gone to sleep for the evening. Quite nice. Toy inventors happen at all ages, right? But this is a behavior of, looks fun to go roller skating, but perhaps a little dangerous. And then if you've ever tried to invent a bath toy, it's really tough because any toy can become a bath toy, right? So these are good little zookeepers, and they're washing their toys before bedtime. This one takes a little bit longer to figure out what it is, so I'll clue you in quickly. It is a busy ghost who's drawing and has some scissors, which scare me a little bit, but it's a good use of a pillow. This is a delightful observation. Taking a look at this and then listening and seeing what the child's doing. This is a little campfire for the cars. So they're out on a little campfire. Accessories matter at any age. So these little guys have been accessorized. They have an iPad and they have a laptop, and how cool is that? So what's going on in this photo, understanding this behavior? There's a little bit of nurturing play here. This is Tigger hunkered down for the evening because it's a cold, cold night and there's snow outside. This is the last one I'll show. This is really touching. Again, some nurturing play. The orange car is sick, and everyone's there to take care of him. So isn't that nice? So all these photographs were from Kalita Stafford, who's our head design researcher at IDEO, and she's delightful. She studied cognitive development. And she calls this play shadows, to go out and observe, and again, really act like the anthropologist, and pick up from these inspirations, and maybe that will turn into something that's unique. I love the story of Scott Stillinger, who was playing ball with his three-year-old, and she couldn't catch it. Most of us would just think, when she gets older, she'll learn to catch. But he saw that and said, maybe there's an opportunity for a better ball, and that's how the Koosh ball came up. But it was inspired by something like a play shadow like this. So I encourage you to really go out and observe and put on that anthropologist's eye and look for some of these play shadows. All right, so one last thing, something to think about. I read an article recently where the average four-year-old laughs something like 40 to 50 times a day. And the average 40-year-old laughs something like 4 times a day. So that's trending just really bad, especially since we're all getting older. So I think in this industry, we're really lucky because we get to create things that cause laughter and joy and play. But more importantly, also along the process, we get to laugh ourselves. But that number really got me thinking about metrics. And it's easy to look at metrics, imagine around financial things. You can look at your bank account, your company's bank account, and you have all these metrics. But what if there was a metric for laughter, and you could look at your laughter bank, and you could see after a day, after a week, after a month, or a year, or a career, how full your bank is? And that's where I feel really lucky at what I do, and I think most of this room probably feel that sort of lucky what you get to do and laugh with your teams. And many of the people here I've known for a long time, I've got to laugh and just have a good time along the way. And think about that, perhaps it's the most important bank account. So I'm going to try to add one last experiment here. We're going to try to add to our laughter account. So now's the time to find that envelope that says do not open until prompted. There's not cash in there, by the way, so don't get. So we're going to try to experiment. There's a balloon in there. We're going to blow these all up, not going to tie them. Then we're going to let them go at the same time. So we're going to see if this is going to work. So blow them up. All right, don't tie them. So don't let them go. All right, at the count of three, hold them up. Hold them up high, guys. Hopefully we didn't lose anyone. 3, 2, 1, go. All right. Thanks, guys. Thank you very much.